With the rapid social and economic development of China, the demand for electric power is increasingly vigorous. In this regard, China has developed and constructed several power generation projects. But because of the geographical limitations, the lack of water resources in areas such as eastern and northern China means that only power plants can be built. And power plants cannot store and reuse when they generate electricity. And the lack of economic means to the peak cause the contradiction of power grid peak regulation in these areas becomes increasingly prominent. To ensure the stable operation of the power grid system. In this regard, the state vigorously built several pumped storage power stations. The pumped storage power station is a new type of power peaking technology. When the power load enters a trough, water from the downstream reservoir is pumped to the upper reservoir. It goes into power storage mode when the power load is at its peak. Water from the upper reservoir is released into the lower reservoir to generate electricity. To meet peak demand for electricity, it can also convert the surplus power when the grid is under low load into high-value electrical energy during peak periods, which is a stable and effective large battery. The development of pumped storage power stations in China is more than 100 years later than that in other countries. But because of the late effect, the starting point is high. Data statistics, China has been built more than 30 pumped storage power stations are under construction. The technology of several large pumped storage power stations constructed in recent years has reached the world's advanced level. Except for the recently installed capacity of the world's largest Hebei Fengning, the pumped storage power station is back online. Construction of another super storage plant has officially begun. February 18, 2020. Shanxi Yuanqu Pumped Storage Power Station project officially started construction. The total investment for the storage plant is nearly 8 billion yuan. It is planned to have a total installed capacity of 1.2 million kilowatts. Four 300 MW generating units will be installed to generate electricity. The project is scheduled to be fully operational by 2028. After the construction of the power station, 500 kV lines will be connected to the Shanxi power grid. The plant is designed to produce 1.2 billion kilowatt hours of electricity annually and 1.6 billion kilowatt hours of electricity annually pumped. And the power station grid into the Shanxi power grid for power supply peak adjustment. It can drive the upstream and downstream industries to resume production and increase the power generation equipment manufacturing industry by about 2 billion yuan. It is worth mentioning that Yuanqu pumped storage power stations can optimize the regulation of the power grid and can assist the operation of the UF power grid. In terms of planning and design, the Yuanqu pumped storage power station will be built on an upper body, thus forming a huge reservoir in the mountains. And beneath the mountain to create a reservoir dam, water along with the mountain's altitude homeward down. The upper and lower reservoirs divert water through a diversion tunnel. Four generators are located just below the mountain. When the demand for power at the Yuanqu pumped storage plant hit a low point, the extra power will drive the turbine and pumps the water. The water from the lower reservoir is pumped into the upper reservoir and converted into potential energy for storage. At peak times, hydropower is generated by opening a dam above it to drain water and deliver power to the local grid. The Yuanqu pumped storage power station can be built in as little as 5 minutes. Complete the conversion of full capacity pumping to power generation to reduce local power consumption. To outsiders, building a pumped storage power station may seem simple. Only two reservoirs will be finished. In fact, the pumped storage power station has many engineering difficulties. The first is leakage from the upper reservoir. Generally, the location of the reservoir on the pumped storage power station is selected. Depression on a leveling surface much higher than the lower reservoir. Mountaintop gully source depression and other landforms. To achieve a large drop, high head of the superior conditions. And the construction of the reservoir is easy to produce a water leakage problem. Therefore, the site selection of the upper reservoir is very important, and strict exploration is needed in the early stage. The quality, nature and stability of leakage are evaluated in detail. Besides, due to the influence of the underground powerhouse and water transmission line and other comprehensive factors, the topographic selection of the reservoir is restricted by many factors. Complete basin topography is difficult to choose, some even protruding mountains. The mountain should be dug into a concave shape during construction. The dam will be built after the upper reservoir is completed. The upper reservoir of a pumped storage power station is a place for storing water and energy. It has a limited amount of water, except for a small amount of leakage and evaporation. The water in the upper and lower reservoir should be recycled. The area is not large and the storage capacity is small, so the upper reservoir cannot leak permanently. It can be said that every pump storage power station in the world is built differently. These are differences in the influence of terrain conditions. China has built many pump storage power stations. But more pump storage power stations will be built in the future because of the rising demand for electricity. And in the construction will encounter all kinds of technical problems. Engineers need to work together to make China's construction technology to a higher level. The Yuanqu pump storage project is just one example of China's power development. Larger pump storage power stations will be built in the future. Ensure the stable operation of China's electric power.